Hey guys, it's Jacob from UnitFlows. Have you ever wondered how to prepare loading animation in Figma? If so, this video is produced specially for you. Enjoy that tutorial and let's get started. For the purpose of this project, I created starting package which contain defining of primitive colors, native components and final materials which you can use whenever you want. You can find a link in description underneath this video. Okay, let's go. Tap F on your keyboard and create first frame. We can adjust size from 100 to 64 pixels. After that, we can add black color from right hand side panel and we should be able to start adding first shapes for our sequences. To do that, tap O on your keyboard and start drawing a circles. I decided to use 6 pixels width for each circle and 8 pixels space between each of them. Adjust paddings from top and bottom and zoom in. I would recommend creating something like 4 lines grid system that will help us to move circles in proper positions. Finally, once we do that, we can duplicate entire frame 7 times. And as a reminder, we should use combination shift plus option button on our keyboard while drag and drop. When this step is done, we can start preparing an accurate position of your circles for each sequence. Follow video and copy exact position for every shape. Alright, so finally, once we do that, we can combine our frames into master components and we can do that by using combination. It's like option command plus K on our keyboard or eventually by using diamond icon in the middle of top bar. And right now we are ready to jump straight to prototype mode. We want to define connections between each sequence. Select after delay and enter 1 millisecond. Change type of animation from instant to smart animate. Adjust from easy out to custom and add modification on curves panel. Time should be set on 90 milliseconds. Repeat for each frame and make sure that all animation values are set properly for each sequence. And when this step is done, we can select all frames and combine them as variants. Don't forget to keep clean inside all of your variants and change property name from property 1, for instance, on animation. And for better look and feel, if you want, you can always add black color for the background, as well as me, and change name from component 1 to loading animation. Yeah, and basically that's it. This is what you need to do in order to create simple loading animation. Screen assumes also circles animation around loading process. So right now we can just lead to part number 2 of this video and start preparing those elements. To do that, tap F on your keyboard in order to create new frame. This time size can be set on 120. It would be also great if we could add black color on our background. After that, you can press O on your keyboard and create a circle. And it would be also worth to mention that we don't need fill in at all. Let's focus on stroke. You can select one of them from my already defined colors or choose by yourself. Set thickness on 5 pixels and inside stroke settings, change type from solid to dash. Also, use 5 pixels as our base value. Duplicate entire frame and place it on right side. We should select second circle and adjust rotation value from 0 to 180. Yeah, and then transform those elements onto master components. And right after that, similar to loading animation, tap on prototype mode and add interaction between those two elements. You can enter value same as me or play around with your own custom approach. At the end of this step, convert those objects onto variants. Add black color for background, set proper name, and basically, that's it. Part number 3 of this video belongs to creating view and placing our animated elements on the screen. I wanna create new frame which will contain proper dimensions of my phone. Usually I use iPhone 13 mini, but you can decide by yourself which device you want to choose. Alright, when you made a decision, let's adjust the name of that screen. Then we can add black color as our base from right hand side panel. As you can see on components page, you should be able to find all necessary native elements such as home indicator, even status bars. Copy and paste them on the screen. For better controlling sizes, we should modify options slightly. Adjust constraints properties and change alignment from left and top to scale. And right now we can take our first circle element and paste that on our screen. Then we can select and resize to 350 pixels. Hey, I wanted to paste another dot circle to make our animation a little bit more appealing. However, in the meantime, I realized we should remove the black fill color from our background because it's hiding some corner parts. Let's adjust that quickly. I'm gonna set second circle to 255 pixels and third one to 155. Right after this step, we are able to choose colors for each element. I'm gonna choose Jakarta for the biggest object, East Bay for middle one, and the smallest one can stays the same. I also wanted to do some kind of depth effect. In this case, I decided to use 4 pixels of layer blur for the biggest one and 2 pixels for the second and third one. Of course, you can play around and modify them as you want. And when it's done, we can insert a loading animation in the middle of those circles. The purpose of this view is to inform users about some loading processes that are happening in the background. For a better experience, we can add text with an explanation of what is happening in the app right now. I already typed generating your data and I wanna select size, type style, and color from defined global values. at the bottom I would like to type loading and create this object as a button in disabled state. You can create an auto layout by pressing Shift plus A and adjust paddings as I did, or you can play around and customize by yourself. Alright, we can adjust spacing a bit and then we can move to the last final stage, which is adding some background colors. My aim is to underline visually middle part of the screen, so I will add a special gradient blur in this place. Draw a circle and add layer blur set on 124 pixels as well as gradient radial color. When I was adding blur, I noticed black background which has been applied to the loading element. For sure, we don't need that. Select all sequences and just delete redundant black color. At the end, for better visual arrangement, we can also add some blurred circle elements, so we can place them at the top and bottom part of our screen. Well, that's all about it. Our loading animation screen seems to be done. If you enjoyed that tutorial, please support my activities by leaving a comment and subscribing my channel. If you reach the end, thanks for your time, and here is our final effect. Enjoy it and see you soon.